Why you don't give me a cup of water?
Why you don't give me water, you idiot? Give me water.
Okay?
Okay. Aqua, water. Aqua, water. You're an idiot. Don't bother me. I'm not interested. You think I'm interested in your...
Reminds me of my days in the service industry. Only in a restaurant I could leave, but these people were on a closed-in plane. Thankfully, they had a solution. Let's watch what happens next.
I asked for water for 2 hours. You're defending them? I asked for water for 2 hours. After 2 hours?
Wow, thank you.
Thank you so much. After 2 hours, I get water. Wow.
The only time you should be applauding on the plane is when someone gets escorted off for being a Karen. So, according to details from the TikTok post, this happened on a November 8th flight from Bangkok to Singapore. The male Karen not only ignored the seatbelt sign to harass and threaten the flight attendant, but he basically wasted everybody's time before security showed up to get him off of the plane. Imagine being on an international flight trying to go somewhere and someone being rude to the flight attendant, asking for water and refusing to wear the seatbelt is what delays you. Absolutely insane. Dina, what are your thoughts on this, Karen?
I mean, come on, we've all been like thirsty on a flight or frustrated we couldn't get up because the seatbelt sign was on for like hours and hours. It's just like you have to get over yourself, and that doesn't give you permission to be so mean, because he was like making fun of him. He was mocking him. He didn't like that maybe that man's, I mean, maybe English was his first language, but he had an accent. He was clearly making fun of that. And I also threatened to assault him. So I'm not sure what happened there, but you can be arrested for that. I mean, he threatened to push him over. So, we're all feeling frustration. You're not, you don't get special privileges. Just sit down, get through it, get the water when you leave the plane.
Yeah, I've been deathly hungover and severely dehydrated on flights before, but I would never talk to a service worker like that. I mean, these people are not paid enough to deal with this kind of behavior, and I don't understand. Actually, I think I do understand why people treat other workers like this, and it is because they've never been in a position where they've had to be a worker in the service industry. And I've heard people say it should be a requirement that everybody, does a little bit of work in the service industry, so you understand what that's like and you treat people a little bit better, because this is ridiculous. It's the kind of perspective that I am better than this other person and I'm entitled to treat them in that way. This is not someone who's treating another human being like they're equal, right? They see themselves as in the right, in a position of power. And things were corrected when they got escorted off of that plane, as far as I'm concerned. And many people agree with that system of justice as they were applauding as he was escorted out.
Absolutely, especially on an airplane where everyone is captive and that service worker, doesn't have a lot of protection. So they have to take that especially seriously on an airplane.
Yeah, thankfully they were not in air when this went down.